Hi everyone, here's a roundup of the top news in Southeast Asia. My name is Angeline and this is the Daily Watch. The Philippines now ranks 20th in countries with the most number of COVID-19 cases globally, with a current total at more than 322,000. This is despite having one of the longest lockdowns in the world. Metro Manila and several other areas remain under the general community quarantine until October 31st. Under GCQ, most businesses can operate partially, but public gatherings remain restricted. Mayors in the National Capital Region are eyeing cancellation of LGU's Christmas parties, with Quezon City, Parañaque, Valenzuela, and Navotas already confirming this, citing that funds saved can be used for anti-COVID-19 response. On Sunday, the country reported 3,190 new daily cases, the highest in almost 2 weeks. In Thai news, Interpol has issued a red notice to arrest Buddha Youth boss Yuvidya, who is wanted for a fatal hit-and-run after crashing his Ferrari and killing a police officer in 2012. As the grandson of Red Bull co-founder Chaleo Yuvidya, the 38-year-old is part of a clan which boasts a net worth of $20.2 billion, making them Thailand's second richest family, according to Forbes. The charges against the fugitive heir were dropped in July, sparking public outrage from Thais who saw it as an example of privilege enjoyed by the kingdom's elite. Thais took to Twitter to express anger using the hashtag #BoycottRedBull. This prompted authorities to reinvestigate the case. The Attorney General's office revealed last month that new evidence has come to light which can be used to prosecute the suspect for reckless driving causing death. Varyut fled the country back in 2017 on a private jet. In finance news, Alibaba is in talks to invest $3 billion into Southeast Asian ride-hailing firm Grab. The funding is about a fifth of Grab's latest known valuation of $14 billion. The Chinese conglomerate will be the sole investor in this funding round and will spend a portion of the funds to acquire some of the Grab stock held by Uber Technologies Incorporated. Uber surrendered its Southeast Asian operations to Grab in March 2018 and took a 27.5% stake in Grab's business. The investment will expand Alibaba's presence in Southeast Asia and will represent one of its biggest investments in the region after its first investment in Lazada in 2016. Under the talks, one of the plans is to integrate Grab's delivery network into Lazada. This combination could help both platforms dominate the e-commerce and ride-hailing services market in the long run. That's it for today. If you liked today's video or learned anything new, press the like button. Subscribe and get the latest news from The Daily Watch. See you next time!